Oh, hey, what's up? It's Bill the Handyman up here in Northern California. How y'all doing today? Today we're looking at a direct drive transmission and motor. As per my name, you know I do recycling. And so I easily save the good parts on the appliances that get recycled. And today we're looking at a couple of transmissions and a motor. This is a typical direct drive motor. These are the typical direct drive transmissions. This is a Whirlpool design, of course. And so what I do is, if you have a motor that's been setting for a long time like this one, and you find that it's frozen, it will not turn, what you could do is just take a little bit of oil or WD-40, and you can spray it up in here, a little bit there, maybe a little bit down in there, there, back in here, and back in here. And then if you look inside there, you'll see where the armature gets very close to the windings. And you can spray a little in there, just enough to moisten it up. And then you can gently sort of pound on the shaft a little bit, and then see if you can turn it. And over time, over time, you'll be able to loosen this up. It depends on how long it's been setting, but generally, I have pretty good luck with these just by spraying a little WD in here and working with them. Putting a little vibration into the main armature, it should come loose. Now, here's your two direct drive transmissions, and what we're going to do is we're going to do some testing. And this one is actually the good one here. So if we turn it to the right, we see that bell turns around clockwise. And that's the proper action. So if we turn this to the right, the bell should go basically the opposite direction. And if we turn it to the left, it's gonna take a little while before it kicks in. But as we turn it to the left, you'll see the center shaft is now agitating back and forth. And so that's the proper action right there. So counterclockwise rotation on the motor creates the agitation in the on the main shaft. And so here is another transmission, and this transmission I wasn't sure about. And so if we go, once again, if we go clockwise, it should spin. So if we do this, we're going clockwise, it starts to spin but doesn't quite spin. And then it goes back into the agitation cycle again. It attempts to spin but does not spin. So I would guess that this is going to be a bad transmission here. This one here will actually agitate if we go counterclockwise. It seems to agitate fine. And seeing how the spin cycle usually takes the brunt of the force, I would imagine the gears inside in the spin cycle are shot on this one. Now for me, I get enough calls to haul off old machines that I don't have to worry about rebuilding it. Some people do rebuild these. They're probably not too hard. I've had them apart a couple of times. Attempted to repair one once. It did not work. And so basically, I just swapped the transmissions. And I've got a lot of good used parts. If you know anybody who's interested in parts, you can contact me, Eureka Recycler@Yahoo. I also give appliance advice for $25. You can contact me via phone if you want, 707-443-8347 Pacific Time. Thanks for watching.